Do you use Box for file storage? Well, let me show you how you can integrate it with Jotform. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you use Box to store files, to share content, or collaborate with your team, you can absolutely integrate your Jotform account so that way your submissions, PDFs automatically go to that file storage. So as you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace, and as of right now, I only have my forms chosen. For this example, we're going to use my tech support form, so let's go ahead and edit our form. And from here, you can see it's a very basic form: name, email, phone number, description of the tech issue they're having, and if they have a file upload. So for this, we're going to go to the top middle, we'll choose settings, and on the left-hand side, we'll choose integrations, and let's go ahead and add Box. Now from here, you'll choose the account that you'd like to work with, and we'll choose to authenticate. And here we want to identify what we want the folder to be called and what the names of the files going to our Box account are going to be named. So as you can see right here, it says enter folder name. Tech support is a good one. We can go ahead and rename that to something else. You can see that it is pulling from the name of my form. Do we want to create a subfolder for each submission? I'm going to go ahead and turn that on. Let's see what that looks like. So we can see the folder name right now, it says submission ID. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that, and I'm going to pull from the form fields. I'm going to pull their name, and let's do a dash, and I'm gonna pull their description from the issue that they're having. Next, we can send the submission PDF to Box. That's going to be the overview of their submission. So let's go ahead and choose that. And then, like I mentioned, we do have a file upload field on our form. Any documents that they upload, we can also send over there. So let's choose that file upload. And the last piece is going to be the metadata. So if you want to add in some metadata, you'll need to have a template already created over in Box. I'm going to choose this one that is already created, and I'm going to have this one be the description as well. All right, let's go ahead and save. All right, so from here, we can see that it's called send files. If you need to, we can rename this action. We can see the action logs every time it has run. We can also disable and delete the action from here. So right here, let's go ahead and click. This is going to open us up in Box in the tech support folder that it just created for us. So I'm going to head back over. Let's do preview form, and I'm going to do a quick fill form. And for the description, I'm going to say trouble with email. And I do have a PDF on my desktop. I'm just going to click and drag in. Perfect. All right, we can finally submit. All right, let's head back over to our tech support folder. I'm going to do a quick refresh. And here is John Smith, trouble with email. Perfect. Now we also see this is the PDF of the submission. And then we also have the PDF that I uploaded into this file. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to integrate your Jotform account with Box, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.